father always said, that it's our dreams that reveal our deepest nature. If that is true, then I'm lost. What is going on? Where the fuck am I? Stay back! Stay away from me! I have to find a way out of here. There's more of them. How many of these things are in here? There must be a way out.
There's so many of them.
Wait. What is this? Where am I? Am I dead? Never seen anything like this before. It's so empty in here.
Please, Ian, you have to hurry.
I can't let her leave.
Come on, Ian. Quickly. I'm sorry, Ian.
No! No!
This is how the nightmares end. Overpowered. Helpless. A sacrifice to violent gods.
I'm sorry, Ian.
No! No!
That one was new. The girl screaming for help. Where the hell did she come from?
I need some water.
18 months of nightmares. Ever since I escaped from that hell. 18 months. Relentless. Unchanging. And suddenly her. She wanted to take me somewhere. What pulled her away like that?
Hallucinations are getting worse every day.
Marcus?
Who else? Sorry to disturb you so late, but I had a bad feeling. How are you?
Not good.
Nightmares? Hallucinations?
Both. But this time it was different. There was a woman, Marcus.
Do you know her?
No. But she seemed familiar. Like I should know her.
Do the pills still work?
Yes, thank you. Not only for this. For everything.
Ian?
I mean it. I turned up out of nowhere with the weirdest story and you believed me. You took me in, let me stay in the beach house, got me medication.
You're my brother, Ian. There's nothing in the goddamn world I wouldn't do for you.
Thanks anyway.
Thank me later. I have a present for you. I found a trace.
The man who took me?
There's a traitor trying to sell a remarkable drug. It's called Nexus, and it's supposed to give the user certain abilities. He's selling to a pretty shady organization tomorrow morning.
Give me his address.
They rented 2 floors of the Crowley Arms, downtown. The place will be brimming with mercenaries, Ian.
I don't care. If he's the lead, I'll be there.
Are you sure you can control it?
Yes.
Good. I will keep on digging and send you the information tomorrow. Rest now. Take the blues if you need them, and gather your strength.
We will bring them down, Marcus. We will burn them to the ground.
Good night, Ian.
Good night. Father always said, only the weak speak to themselves. But I like it. It keeps me focused. Helps me make sense of this mess. 3 years I'm missing from my memory. 3 years between stepping out of a plane from Syria and waking up on a highway in England. I have no idea what went on in that time. But something changed in me. Something I can't explain. My mind is not the same anymore. I can see and do things that should not be possible. I have somehow gained a power that I can barely control. A power that's turning me insane. Whatever has been done to me, I'm still a soldier. And a human being. If I hold on to these thoughts, I will survive. I should check my gun before the morning. I'll need it tomorrow. Who do you turn to when you are lost? Your family. Marcus was smarter than I. He left the service long before me, made his fortune as a doctor. He was there for me, and still is. Resignation papers. No idea how Marcus got hold of them. I don't even remember quitting. Did the army turn me in? I've read many accounts of outer body experiences throughout the world, but nothing like my own. At will, I can leave my body and see myself from the outside. Marcus is a well-connected man, but despite his contacts, our investigation into my disappearance has only drawn blanks. We can't find no one who shares my story, no clues or pieces that fits the puzzle. But this drug, this Nexus, it's the strongest lead we've had so far. Marcus insists that I keep a dream diary. He says it's vital that I record all hallucinations and dreams. The entries are always the same. Horrific locations. Violent deaths. But last night was different. The woman calling my name. She has to mean something. I know what you're thinking. What normal person built a shooting range in their basement? I'm not a normal person. Besides, it was Marcus' idea. He thought it would help with my recovery. Routine is good for a soldier. Marcus believes my powers are a gift. I should master them. But he doesn't know what it's like to feel the very sanity being drained from your mind. That's why I try to do things the old-fashioned way. If I keep my skills sharp and remember my training, I shouldn't. It's getting late. I should get some rest before tomorrow. What's that sound? Is there a bird in the house? I should get some sleep. All right. Concentrate. No nightmares. The woman from my dream last night, she has to mean something. I know it. Maybe if I focus on her, she will come back. She was beautiful. Figures again. This one is different. It's not moving. I'll have to find a way out before he wakes up. All the pieces are set. But where's the king? It's not a way out, but at least I found the king. The pieces have been reset. A chess riddle? I haven't got time to play games. I'll find another way out of here. This. The king? But I just dropped it. So you really want that game, huh? You don't know who you are dealing with. I learn from the best. Let's see. The king is useless. I can either move the queen, the pawn, or the rook. But if I move any of them, the others will be beaten. Is that what it's about? Sacrifice? All right. Like my old man taught me, sacrifice the weakest piece.
What the hell? Why can't I breathe? What's going on? Fuck. How do I stop this? It must be the game. I have to put the palm back. It stopped. When the pawn is in danger, so am I. Is this supposed to mean something? Am I the pawn? Are these people? Who would the other pieces be? Either way, there's only two other choices here. Sacrifice the queen, or the rook. Some kind of switch. Maybe that controls a door. I can reach it with my mind. Never projected that far before. I hope I can reach it. That's more like it. Shit, you're overdoing it, Ian. Lucky there are some blues here. I can't keep on with a migraine like this.
Thank you.
station. Switches.
I'm so happy to see you. They said I couldn't go to you, that you were still sick, but I knew they were lying. Can you hear me? Ian? Can you give me a sign? Do you remember the first gift you gave me? That old, ugly baseball bat. You thought it would impress me. It did. It had been such an awful day. I was scared and desperate and lonely. And then, there was you, standing in the hallway, cheeks red with anticipation. Do you remember what you said? Happy V-Day. You thought that adults talked like this, always in abbreviations. You wanted to sound cool, even though you were nervous. I fell in love with you then and there. I knew that you would be my savior, my protector, my love. You would never forsake me, never betray me, never forget me. You remember me, Ian, don't you?
It all sounds so familiar. But I can't remember this.
Do you remember the first gift you gave me? That old, ugly baseball bat. You thought it would impress me. It did. It had been such an awful day. I was scared and desperate and lonely. And then, there was you, standing in the hallway, cheeks red with anticipation. Do you remember what you said? Happy V-Day. You thought that adults talked like this, always in abbreviations. You wanted to sound cool, even though you were nervous. I fell in love with you then and there. I knew that you would be my savior, my protector, my love. You would never forsake me, never betray me, never forget me. You remember me, Ian? Don't you?
Sounds so familiar, but I can't remember this.
Square one. I'm going in fucking circles. At least this guy hasn't moved anywhere. The pieces have been reset.
All right. Time for a second go. This time I will sacrifice a rook.
Notes on perception. I guess this is going to involve some time manipulation.
Thank you.
not alone. I don't have a weapon, but maybe I don't need to kill him. Gonna have to sneak by. It would help if he was moving a bit slower. These guys in here. What the hell is supposed to happen here? It's hurling blocks at me. Stopped. I can't wait to get out of here. There's more of them. Remember that song? Marcus and I had to practice it over and over. One of Dad's favorites.
Ian, how nice of you to come. I'm very happy with your progression. The nurses say you've been a very good boy this week. Come. You may sit on my lap. There's one thing I wanted to talk to you about. There's a force in the world that is stronger than fear. Even stronger than love or hate. That force is duty. Good men are governed by their duty. A deep feeling for right and wrong. Duty has us do things that are beyond our own morality. Shaking every pillar of our personality to the core. There are real monsters in this world, Ian. Not hiding under your bed, but in plain sight. Smiling at you across the breakfast table, staring at you in the mirror. There are abysses in every man and every woman. And duty helps us control them. Control ourselves.
No! No!
Now, there's one thing I wanted to talk to you about. There's a force in the world that is stronger than fear. Even stronger than love or hate. That force is duty. Good men are governed by their duty. A deep feeling for right and wrong. Duty has us do things that are beyond our own morality. Shaking every pillar of our personality to the core. There are real monsters in this world, Ian. Not hiding under your bed, but in plain sight. Smiling at you across the breakfast table, staring at you in the mirror. There are abysses in every man and every woman. And duty helps us control them. Control ourselves. If we lose control, the world burns and the monsters win. Will you remember that, Ian? Your brother. He's been a naughty boy this week, and Daddy needs to have a word with him.
I wonder if Marcus would remember this. Dad's lectures. How have I forgotten them? How can a dream uncover memories buried so deep in the past?
Of course. What now? What options are left?
I remember this.
This was my hand. And this one was...
Let me go! You were in my house. Who are you? What are you doing?
It's time to wake up, Ian. It's time to open your eyes.
No! No! Ah!